Hey guys, welcome back. And today I wanted to talk to you guys about new releases or soon to be released products, and are they going into my shopping cart? Now, as you guys know, I have been in the past year, maybe a little bit over a year, have actually been trying to be a more of a conscious consumer. But you do guys also know that I love makeup, so here and there I would buy one or two stuff, but I'm no longer the hoarder that I was. In fact, I have stopped subscribing to beauty gurus because of all the hauls that they do, and also I'm stuck following some Instagram accounts like Trend Mood or stuff like that. But for the purpose of this video, I did actually follow Trend Mood once again because I wanted to see what's up in makeup, as Jen Loves Reviews would say, so that I could tell you guys if it is something that I think is worth the money, or am I not gonna put that on my shopping cart. So it's more like the anti hauls that I used to make, but also if there are some that actually tweaks or piques my interest, then I might put them in my wish list. Okay, so let's start up. I have here about 15 products that are, yeah, or is this 15? I think so. Yeah, 15 products that I want to look at. The first thing is actually not a new product, but it's a release of newer shades. And this is by Too Faced, and this is their Born This Way foundation. Now, apparently they are adding a few more shades here. I'm not sure exactly how many. And this is in collaboration or a team up with Jackie Aina. Now, if you don't know who Jackie Aina is, where have you been living? She's a beautiful person of color. And one of the things that has been rampant in the beauty industry, in the makeup lines, is that their foundations are always usually geared towards light to medium shades. People of darker skin tones or much fairer skin tones are often left out in that. And I kind of understand that, because obviously they're trying to cater to the larger range. However, obviously they can't capture everybody, and it's gonna cost a lot of money for them to produce those, although they make a ton of money anyways. But I digress. So Too Faced is coming out with deeper shades of their Born This Way foundation. I have never tried this foundation before. I have heard mixed reviews about it. I guess it depends on how your skin reacts, as with many foundations. So I don't know if I'm actually going to be trying this, because I am still going through my Estee Lauder Perfectionist. I've got two MAC foundations, three actually, because my face and body is still also there. And I also have my IT Cosmetics CC cream. So I think I'm going to pass on to this, but kudos on them for coming out with more shades to cater to and include more people of color, as well as lighter shade, lighter complexions. But I think this is more to do with how Tarte's Shape Tape foundation was received by the general public and how much shit they got for it. So a lot of brands are finally going like, okay, we don't want to get into that kind of hot water, so let's churn out some more shades. I think that's what's going on here. In relation to that, and having just said that, Jouer is actually coming out with 50 shades of foundations. Yes, I believe that's, yeah, they're adding 33 to their existing line, which already has 17, so it's gonna be a total of 50 shades of foundation. And again, to be honest, I think this is just their way of covering their ass. When people ask, why are you only catering to this range of skin tones and excluding people of much, much darker color or much, much lighter shades. So yeah, they're coming out with 33 more shades. Yeah, and I really think that's just them trying to make sure that they don't get shit for the shade range that they currently have in their foundation. Now, moving on, Becca has come out with another Shimmering Skin Perfector highlighter, and it is in the shade Chocolate Geo. Now, I'm going to be obviously putting in pictures of the products that I'm mentioning. Now, these are really dark. And I have medium skin tone. I am usually an NC37 on Mac. When it's summer, I'm an NC40. When it's winter, I'm an NC35. So I just have the NC35 and the NC40 and just mix them together. Anyways, I digress once again. Okay, so this is a really nice one. And if you are somebody who has got really dark skin, it looks beautiful on the model that they're using on this advert. If you have really pale skin, I think this would work as more of a shiny bronzer. And with the Shimmering Skin Perfector line, you know that they are the kind that really, when the light hits it, it's like really shiny. So I don't know if you like shiny bronzers, then that might work for you. Even for my skin tone, it's gonna be more of a bronzer. And you really need to have really dark skin to be able to pull this off as a highlighter. I do like the Becca Skin Perfector line. I have Opal, and I used to have Moon. What is it called? Moonstone and Topaz. This is even darker than Topaz. If you have ever used Topaz, I used Topaz before as an eyeshadow because I just can't pull it off for as a highlighter. So there you go. Even when I am tanner than I am now, it just doesn't work on me. So this one is probably going to be even darker. So I'm gonna pass on this one. Okay, the next one is a ColourPop collaboration with Eva Gutowski, or My Life is Eva. The eyeshadows are quite interesting, and so is the, I don't know if this is it looks like it's a blush and a highlight. Let's just have a look. It's a face duo called Mermaid Glow. If you're looking at the same picture that I'm looking at, first of all, one of the eyeshadows quads is more on a cool tone, and the other one is more warm tone. Now, these aren't shades that I have never seen before. These are shades that are pretty common, and I do believe I have all of those shades from both quads in my current collection, so I'm not really keen on that. But the face duo is something that intrigues me, and I do like the shades of that. I just don't get why it's called Mermaid Glow, Mermaid Glow, when there is nothing mermaidy about the shades on here. One is a muted gold, and then the other one is Siren, which looks more like a peachy nude blush in a light pink palette. How is that mermaid? When I think of mermaid, I think of purples and greens and holographic glitter. There is nothing mermaidy in this one, so I don't know why it's called Mermaid Glow. And given that mermaids are figments of our imagination, until you can prove otherwise, I guess nobody really knows how the mermaids glow, so I don't, yeah. Whatevs. But I am interested in that. They also have here three liquid lipsticks. I believe the lip bundle has got ultra glossy lip and ultra blotted lip. What does that mean? That's the first one. They've got two of the ultra blotted lip and one of the glossy lip. I haven't tried any of those formulas from them. I do like their satin lip liquid lipsticks, so I might be interested in getting those, that bundle as well. And the shades are pretty, like one of them has got like iridescent shades, like it's pretty glossy, almost like a lip topper. So that might be something that I might be interested in as well, and they are shades that work well in my skin tone, so those are going in my wish list. Next is from Looxi, L-O-O-X-I Beauty. And they are a collection of eyeshadows. It says Looxi has reformulated their highlights and eyeshadows, and they feel amazing. I'm on the dupe that Instagram. They are so rich, velvety, and intensely pigmented. So they come in five shades. Oh, nine, actually. Nine shades that I'm looking at. They look really nice, but I don't really believe in the swatches of these Instagrammers, because I know that some of them would put not just a primer, but would actually apply it wet. And as you can see in the picture here, if that is the real color, then wow. But the thing is, a lot of the times it's not, and even with finger swatches, they usually apply much more pigmented and higher impact than when you're using a brush. So I would much rather see how this actually apply with a brush, because I use a brush on my eyelids. I don't use my fingers on them, right? So, but very interesting, especially platinum pink and ruby rain. They are calling my name, as well as magma. Loving those shades. I'm gonna have to look into this and see if I can get them. Now, none of the highlighters called there's Forbidden, Temptress, and Innocent. None of them are really calling out my name. Mostly because when I look at the swatches, they are quite glittery, and I like my highlights to be a little bit more natural. Especially since I work in a corporate environment, and I wouldn't want to buy a product that I can only use during the weekends. So I'd rather be able to use something that buy something that I can use every day, and these aren't it. Okay, next is from Kim Kardashian, KKW Beauty, Kim Kardashian West. They are coming out with baking powder, brightening powder, and concealers. And each item is at $18. So, they've got loose powders. They've got pressed powders. Is this pressed powder or concealer? Yeah, brightening powder and baking powder. So the brightening powder are pressed, the baking powders are loose, and then you've got a shit ton of concealers that they're coming out with. Kudos to them. To her on doing this. Not gonna be buying that because I don't support any of the Kardashians. Don't ask me why, I just don't. Pretty Vulgar is coming out with a Phoenix Rising eyeshadow palette, and it looks really like Phoenix Rising because it's very sort of like fire inspired, with a lot of oranges and burnt oranges and stuff like that. I just don't know if I will like this. I'm looking at the swatches. They're very pretty, but a lot of them are quite dark. And if you're looking at the same picture that I'm looking at, which is what's on the screen right now, I don't know. I'm not convinced that I want it. The Devilish Darling shade is so pretty though. And the same with Resurrected Sun. So I am interested in this. This might go into my wish list. I have not tried any of the Pretty Vulgar formulas or eyeshadows or any product from that brand at all. So I'm curious as to how they perform. Am I going to be spending $35 on this palette? I don't know yet. Next is something from BH Cosmetics, and they are called Diamond Dazzlers and Base Booster Glitter and Shadow Glue, $7 each. When I first saw this picture, I was like, whoa, are they coming out with something similar to what Stila came out, like their Shimmer and Glow liquid eyeshadows? And is it Glimmer and Glow as well? There's like two kinds. One is more Glitter and Glow, and Shimmer and Glow, I think is what it is. And I'm more interested really with the Shimmer and Glow, because again, something that I would be able to use every day and not just on special occasions. So when I first saw this, I was like, wow, I want one of those. I mean, I want in on that. But then I read a little bit more, and they're actually just glitter pigments that you put on a base. So if I buy a glitter glue, let's say from NYX, I have one from e.l.f., which works well anyways. And I put on any glitter on top of it, why'd I have to pay $7 for each one when I can get like a teaspoonful of glitter from TKB Cosmetics or one of those like little wholesalers that are the same, if not better quality. Yeah, so nope, not gonna be buying that. Here, Trend Mood just posted that there is a fun collaboration between the Face Shop and Coca-Cola, wherein they've got, what is this? There's an eyeshadow palette with 9 shades in it. And I believe there's a cushion foundation. Oil clear blotting. Yeah, oil control powder as well. Cushion, oil control. Oh, so there is cushion foundation. And some lipsticks or lip products. Liquid lipsticks as well. That's Coca-Cola. The shades are quite cute, actually. I don't know. Maybe I will actually test that. They look pretty. Lip tints as well. I am actually loving lip tints. I'm in love with my Bennett tint. Because it gives me that tint and that hydration. And makes my lips look quite young. Not like this. Anyway, I am very curious about this. There's Face Shop here in Australia, so I might pop in and see if they have this. When is this coming out? So they've got lipsticks, lip oil, lip tint, eyeshadow palette, cushion, oil control, and more things are coming out. This is only available in Asia, though. A lot of the stuff that are available in the Asian market are available here in Australia. So I don't know if this is coming out to Australia, but if it is, I am looking at that eyeshadow palette and I'm looking at those lip tints that I may be purchasing. Okay. Next is, Stila just came out with a new glitter and glow liquid eyeshadow in Coral Crush, and it is gorgeous. But like I said, I prefer their shimmer and glow just because it's a little bit more wearable. But this color is gorgeous. Like, it's pink and gold at the same time. So yeah, it's calling my name. I swear it's calling my name. Stay tuned to that because I might actually pick this one up. It says it's $24. Here in Australia, it's $35. It really is calling my name. Okay. K-Palette, if you are into Korean beauty products, K-Palette is a Korean beauty product. Oh. No, it's Japanese, actually. I lied. Okay, so it is a Japanese product, and they are coming out with their lasting lip tint stick. I think Asian brands are into the lip tint nowadays. Because, like, Face Shop and now K-Palette, they are in sort of like a lip balm container. It looks like a lipstick, but in a lip balm formula that tints your lips. It comes in 4 shades, and I am digging it. I think I'm gonna pop into my closest W Cosmetics branch. W Cosmetics is an Asian beauty store here in Australia. So, and see if they actually have this. Okay, I already talked about Juwe. Oh, Laura Geller is coming out with liquid highlighters. Now, given the fact that Laura Geller's highlighters, like their baked gelée highlighters, are so popular, I'm surprised that it took them this long to jump into the liquid highlighter bandwagon. It's coming with 4 shades, Gilded Honey, which is one of their more popular baked gelée ones, Diamond Dust, Opal Crush, and Ballerina. They look really pretty. I am looking quite interested at Diamond Dust. However, I'm not really a big fan of liquid highlighters. In fact, I have my Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector liquid highlighters in the trio, the small ones. I still have them, and they're so hard to use up. And I'm thinking that, what I've started to do was actually add them to my body moisturizer, so it gives me a little bit of a glow just for me to be able to use them up, because honestly, it's taking forever. Ah, here's one. So, anyways, going back to Laura Geller, I probably won't purchase that because I still have quite a few highlighters and I don't really need any more. I mean, let's face it. Now, let's go with a Disney palette. Hot Topic is coming out with a Moana Heart of Tefiti eyeshadow palette. Now, I haven't seen the Disney animation, so I can't really speak about it. But I'm looking at this eyeshadow palette and thinking to myself, who is the target market for this palette? Because if we're looking at it, I just don't see how this is a cohesive palette. There's a lot of greens, a lot of cream shades. There's one sort of lilac-y lavender shade. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if these are for adults. Because even with the packaging and the way... is that one in the center a highlighter? If it is, it looks green to me. So I don't know. I'm not picking this up. Yeah, it's on sale for $11.17 from $14.90, and I think I understand why it's on sale. Because nobody wants to buy it. I mean, looking at that, and even like how the mirror is shaped is weird. You've got all that space, and you put a mirror that's half the size of the lid. Why? So yeah. I think this is something that if you've got a kid who's starting out with makeup, they might enjoy. But as an adult, I mean, I know that there's a lot of Disney fans out there who even in their adult life would like to purchase and support Disney, but I'm not one of them. So I'm sorry. I'm not buying that. It just looks like kid makeup. Okay, next. Yeah, Maybelline is coming out with their spring summer eyeshadow palette. It's called the Lemonade Craze, and it's a warm palette with a pop of yellow. That's what it is. I'm looking at it right now. There's not a lot of dark shades there to be able to deepen an eyeshadow look. I think they're trying to copy Modern Renaissance a little bit with this because it's quite warm with that one yellow. It's a lemonade palette with one yellow. Now I understand there's grapefruit lemonades, there's strawberry lemonade, there's a lot of like other lemonades out there, but when I think lemonade, I think yellow, I think mint green, maybe. Yeah, lime green, not really reds or browns. So maybe it's just me, but I'm not digging this palette. I'm not gonna be buying that. No. ColourPop is expanding their concealer collection. I think again in response to how Tarte Shape Tape got shit. They now have 8 shades for fair, 8 shades for medium, 8 shades for light, 8 shades for medium dark, 8 shades for dark, and 8 shades for deep. Coming soon. I haven't tried their concealer, and I really have no desire to. I still have an unopened Maybelline Fit Me concealer, which is my favorite, and I still have my MAC Conceal and Correct concealer palette. So, not gonna be trying this out anytime soon, at least. Maybe eventually, but not right now. Oh, and I think that's it. And I've talked for 25 minutes about things that I'm not really interested in. Maybe one or two stuff might go into my wish list. But what do you think about these releases? Let me know in the comment section down below if you're going to be purchasing any of them. If not, why not? Okay. And I think that's it. Subscribe if you haven't already. Give me a thumbs up if you like these kinds of videos. And I probably will try and do this every 2 weeks, depending on how many releases are coming out. With the summer and the spring coming, in Northern Hemisphere, I think there's going to be a lot more coming out. So anyways, I'm going to go now because this is way too long. Bye!